Hey, welcome to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by Ogio Powersports and FMF Racing. I'm Don Maeda, and today I'm joined by my good friend H.Rey Gubernick, otherwise known as Dr.G.
Wow, well, right? Not too many people know that name.
Say so H.Rey?
I'm impressed. H.Rey, that's some talent and just intellectual thinking and detective work finding out my name.
I've known that for years, but what is the H? It's H period Ray.
For the sake of pure being heckled for the rest of my life, I don't think I'm going to devote. No,
Howard
stands for Harold Ray Gubernick, but my dad doesn't even go by Harold, so I don't go by that. I go by H. Ray Gubernick.
H. Ray.
And then the very first day I was in practice, I heard Dr. Gubernick about 100 times. I was like, I can't do that. Call me Dr. G. It's way easier.
Okay, so Gubernick, that doesn't seem like I'm just assuming, but you're from Hawaii?
Well, I mean, that's where my roots are from, but Gubernick is my father's adopted name.
Okay.
So it's German, Russian descent, but I don't look like a Gubernick, I don't think, but that's why I go by Dr. G. It's way easier.
Okay, so Dr. G is a chiropractor. The practice is natural health.
Sports therapy. Good job.
See, I just see him at the track.
Just see me at the track.
But you cannot attend a professional motocross or supercross and be in the pits without seeing Doc G working on 1, 2, 3, 10, 20 guys, right?
Wow. More like 10.
10.
Yeah, 20 would be a little bit too much.
Yeah. So in my days at Trans World Motocross, I think I was introduced to you by our good friend, Eric Biggie Bartoldus.
Oh yeah, Biggie.
I think I was out. My back was out real bad, and he's like, "You gotta go see Doc G." And I'm all, "The guy that's at the races?" And he's like, "Yeah." And he brought me in, and you've been taking care of me ever since. So.
I remember that. There's been quite a few opportunities that you've been in my office. Always hurt, but I'm not offended by that.
Yeah, this sport is a sport of motocross and supercross, and even for me, mountain biking, it keeps guys like you busy.
Yeah, it does. I mean, that's a good and a bad thing, right? But it's been cool to benefit from other people's mishaps is not a good thing. But I enjoy helping people as much as I can. And, you know, Don's been one of those guys. And like you said earlier, I've had a chance to put my hands on most motorcycle guys throughout my career here. And it's been amazing. I really enjoy what I do and love to help people as much as I can. So it's one of the greatest jobs on the planet, I think.
Nice. How did you become like the action sports chiropractor doctor?
Wow, that's a question that's been asked several times. I got introduced into motocross by Garth Tarlow was the team manager for a surf team.
O'Neill.
And he knew Tim Ferry. And at the time, Tim was struggling with some arm pump issues, and they were friends. And he said, "Hey, why don't you come check out my friend who helps a lot of the surfers?" I was working on the surf tour at the time, and brought Tim Ferry out, and we were able to kind of help his situation. And I met Tim, and then through Tim, I met Ezra Lusk, and then every year I started working with somebody.
More and more.
Now it's...
So Red Dog was your
Red
first
Red Dog
motocross
was my game. Very first. It's all his fault that I never see my family.
I know. So these days, though, you go to almost every race, right?
Yeah, when I first started back in the day, this kind of dates me a little bit, it was Supercross, and then outdoors was Saturday and Sunday. Mm-hmm. And I just wasn't able to get back to my practice in time, so I kind of only did Supercross. And then when it changed and the outdoors was just on Saturday, then I started doing full-time, and that's the fault of Ivan Tedesco. So we'll blame that on him. And Red Dog was the one, my very first motocross guy that I ever worked on. And I didn't know anything about it. I remember the very first race I went for him was in Vegas, and he had won the East Coast title. And he went out, and I was sitting in the stands, and he went to do a knack-knack, and I thought he was falling off the bike. I knew nothing about motorcycles, and it kind of scared me. I was like, "Oh my gosh, he's falling off the bike." And then he went back on, and I was just hooked right at that moment. I was like, this is a cool sport. I'd love to know more about it and learn more about it. And I've been hooked ever since. Even though it's my profession, I'm the biggest fan.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like the motocross guys get hurt more or more severely than your other sports athletes?
I would say yes. I mean, it might not be as frequent as some of the other guys. I work with skateboarders and I work with surfers and I work with anything that you see on X Games, but the motocross athletes, when it is something, it's usually something bad. It's mm-hmm. a fracture or they blow out their knee or wrist. And so it is a more serious injury when a guy hurts himself on a motorcycle for mm-hmm. sure.
Definitely. And you have, for me firsthand, I mean, you've been able to heal me a lot faster than like my medicinal doctors would, traditional medicine. What is it about chiropractic that regular doctors sometimes like to poo-poo on?
It's unfortunate that it happens. I mean, we all have our spot in the industry. I love Dr. Bodner. I think having him at the races and what he is able to do for people is amazing. Mm-hmm. I just am in a different lane. We all have to pick our lanes. And when we stay in our lanes, I think it's beneficial. There's times where you need medicine, times where you need medication, mm-hmm. you got a cold, you know, go and see your chiropractor. It will help, but it's not going to be the answer. It's not going to get rid of your cold. But I've been fortunate enough to stay in my lane. I know mm-hmm. what I can do. I know what I do well, and I try and just do that. I don't try and overstep my boundaries. And my expertise is helping people prepare for it, and when they get hurt, it's trying to get them better as fast as I can, and I think I'm pretty decent at that.
Mm-hmm. And you've got a lot of through the years, you've had a lot of like new technology gadgets, gizmos in your office that I've been like, man, what is that? Like, I think the first time you put the magnet on me,
I remember that.
I was like, dude, what is that? And then it worked great, right? And then I see Twitch bought one and Matto bought one, and all these guys own them because they want to have it in the convenience of their house. And then the latest thing you had was that.
It's called an acoustic sound wave.
It was like a
looks like a gun.
Yeah. And you're all, this is gonna hurt.
I remember that. So you know what? These hands can only do so much.
Yeah.
And you gotta be on the cutting edge of technology. Bikes have gotten better. And you know, there's so much out there that's able to help people. And I want to be able to help them the best that I can. So I'm always researching in my brain, looking on things on the internet of mm-hmm. ways and technologies that are maybe over in Europe that we're not allowed to use.
Yeah, how do you stay on top of the latest and greatest?
You just kind of have to Google.
Research it yourself.
You know, you have to research it yourself, look at some things that they're using over in Europe because they're always on the cutting edge and they're able to use a little bit some of the tools that we are not familiar with here.
Yeah.
And so some of those are straight from Europe. We have that pulsed electromagnetic frequency mm-hmm. machine, the magnet that everybody has. And you know, it works so well. I take it to the races with me on the weekends. That's that box everybody sees me carrying around. Mm-hmm. But you know, there's always new technology and I'm always trying to be on the cutting edge because time is of the essence when you're helping these guys. You got to get them back on the bike as fast as you can or they'll just go see someone else. So
yeah.
I pride myself on that. I think, you know, there are some of those ones where people, you know, raise their eyebrows. And say, oh, that's one of those laser machines, lights and hocus pocus stuff, whatever it is. But I mean, the reality is actions speak louder than words. And mm-hmm. I take pride in getting my guys out there as fast as I can. And whatever we have to use, that's within the legal limits that we're going to do. If it's a machine and you know I'm always looking at different taping techniques and whatever we can do to get the guys mm-hmm. back on the bike as fast as we can.
Yeah, there's always been something that you do to me that I'm always like, wait, what? Like, remember that time I crashed and I had that huge hematoma on my hip and my hips were like this big?
I remember.
And
that.
You put that tape on me, you cut it, and later that you told me to take it off in a couple of days and I peeled it off and the big bruise on me was like checkered
So that was kinesio tape, and I remember when that first came out, I was even blown away myself. I saw, I was watching the Olympics, and I saw an Olympic volleyball player had it on her shoulder, and I went, what is that? So, you know, got on the internet myself and kind of checked out some research, and it was called kinesio tape, and it was back when nobody was using it. Mm-hmm. And I remember I was able to get a hold of some and experimented in my office with some of the athletes, and I remember you happened to be there, and a lot of the things surprised myself too. And I remember I put it on a pattern, and when you take it off, it draws that inflammation and the bruising away.
Yeah.
And it's surprising to people how a piece of tape with little a special technique on the underside of the tape can actually do something like that. But that's what I love. You got to step out of your comfort zone a little bit when you're doing it. If you just do the same thing every time, sometimes you get caught in those, it's boring. You want to step out of your boundaries, time is of the essence with these guys. If they're out 1 week, that's one thing. If they're out 2 weeks, they're out 3 weeks, then they're that's done the with the season, championship, and then their chances of their dream coming true of winning a championship is gone.
Yeah. All right. Well, hey, we're going to take a quick break to hear from our show sponsors, but we'll be back for more with H.Rey. Hey, welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show, presented by Ogio Powersports and FMF Racing. Joined today by Dr. G, the world famous bodyguard of Ivan Tedesco, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So
that's your fault.
So, Doc G used to hang out at the in the truck. What team was Ivan on that time?
Pro Circuit.
Pro Circuit team.
Yeah, Pro Circuit. Ivan
was the rider who had contracted G to come to the races, and you were always around. And people would say, "Hey, who is that guy?" Like, I remember one time someone from the outside of the pits was like, who's that guy? I go, that's Ivan Tedesco's bodyguard.
Oh, man.
So we used to write that in the magazine all the time, and you actually started getting recognized as that.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, I did. And it wasn't always a good thing. I remember that someone came up to me one time and said, "Hey, Dr. G, can I have your autograph?" And I was blown away. It was the very first autograph anyone had ever asked for me. He says, as I'm signing it, I'm thinking, what do I write? I mean, this person doesn't know I'm Ray Gubernick. So I write Dr. G, and he goes, "Thanks, you're the best bodyguard in the pits." And I was like, oh man, Don, here he goes again. So yeah, I owe you one for that.
Nice. All right, so early on we were talking about, it was Red Dog that got you in.
Yes.
Of all the big name riders in the sport, like, it's probably easier to name the ones that you haven't worked on since that period than the ones that you have, right?
You know, that's crazy you should ask that. I just got asked that in my office the other day. And one person that I never worked on, and I kind of wish I would have, was Travis Pastrana. Never worked on Travis during his career. But at one time or another, I've pretty much put my hands on
some. Let's all fire off some names.
Go for it.
James Stewart.
Yes.
What?
So James was, Ezra introduced him to me when he was at Cowie, when he was, first started off and he was a little kid. And I knew he was something special when I first put my hands on it. He never really liked the whole chiropractic side of it. He liked the stretching and the tissue work. But yeah, worked with James early in his career when he had that Bubblicious jersey. I still have one. In fact, I found it in my garage the other day.
Nice.
Yeah.
Ryan Dungey.
Come on. It's like Ryan and I go way back. I'll never forget the first time he asked me to work with him. He was 16 years old and he was at Suzuki. I didn't even know who he was. In fact, Big E was the one that introduced us. And, he was all fidgeting with his food. And I could tell he was going to ask me to work with him during the year. And, he's not making eye contact. This is when younger Ryan Dungey. He's like, hey, Dr. G, would you work for me this year? I don't really know what you do, but I think you would really help me out. So I helped him out, showed up to that Atlanta race, and he won. I was like, whoa, this is a good get. So, worked with Ryan throughout his whole career. He was a pleasure to work with.
Yeah. Chad Reed.
Chad Reed is kind of a weird situation. Chad was always the enemy. Because I worked with Ivan, and I worked with Ricky, and I worked with Ryan, and Chad was never kind of, and then all of a sudden, I don't know what happened in the last 3-4 years. It's like, I don't know if I matured and Chad matured, but all of a sudden, one time he called me up, he's like, hey, G, I got something going on. It was in the middle of a race, and he said, would you come over here and help me out? And I was like, my jaw dropped down to the ground. My eyes got this big, and I was like, Chad Reed? Like, yeah. The Chad Reed, and I can't believe he's asking me, because I didn't ever think we saw eye to eye. And I went over there, and just like always happens, he's like the nicest guy. And Chad and I have been pretty tight. In fact, I worked on Chad during the whole time when he was with Cooper as teammates at Yamaha. And we became pretty good friends. We've hit it off. And Chad comes in the office every time he's around and needs something. So, nice. Yeah, I've worked with Chad Reed as well.
Were you the guy who gave him the box to put his food in and push the
button?
That
was not me. I will leave that name off my lips. No, I did not help him with that.
All right, so who's the most high maintenance rider that you've worked with?
That I've ever worked with, yeah. Or that I work with now? Or
now and ever.
Zach Osborne? For sure. Not in a bad way, but just he knows what he wants, and that's not a bad thing. High maintenance is, I mean, my wife's high maintenance, but I love her.
Yeah. Okay, how, like, ever then?
Ever? I would still put Zach Osborne
first?
Yeah,
sure. Yeah. So what's so high maintenance about him?
He just knows what he wants, and he has this brain that in the next life, he will be a doctor, for sure. Dr. Yeah. Osborne. So every time something happens, he thinks it's either cancer, a tumor, or something. And I'm like, Zach, it's not cancer, I promise you. So yeah, Zach's high maintenance, but I love him to death. He makes it fun. Every time something happens, he thinks it's broken, or it's a tumor or cancer.
Okay, so our photo up there is you and Cooper Webb with the number one plate.
Wow.
You obviously worked with Coop last year.
Yes, I did.
And continue to, I'm sure.
I've worked with Cooper for 5 years now, and time flies, but he's a real enjoyable guy. I'll never forget, I was working with Team RCH back in the day, and I met Cooper. Will Hahn brought him to my office, and he had some issues, and I kind of helped him out. He's a real quiet kid, and he was in Oakland and had a bad crash. I don't know if you remember that. It's where his motorcycle in practice hit the side of Oakland Stadium and made the biggest sound. It sounded like a bomb went off. And I was in the RCH rig, and I hear this knock at the door, and someone holding his wrist, and Candy Watson goes, hey, there's that Webb kid that's out there. He wants to talk to you. And I said, Webb, what? Who? Cooper Webb. Oh, he's not one of my guys. So I went out there, and it was Cooper, and he, with those little droopy eyes, he kind of looked at me. He goes, Dr. G, my wrist's killing me. Can you help me? And I felt sorry for him at the time. Yeah. I was like, yeah, I'll help you out. And, we did some stuff, and, his wrist had kind of like subluxated out a little bit. We worked on it, and he went on to do pretty good that night. And he came back in, he goes, what's it gonna take for me to work with you? That was very helpful. And I was able to, he's always been very appreciative, Cooper has. And we've been working together ever since.
Nice. Does it ever get uncomfortable for you if you're working with one rider and someone else asks for your help? Like, if one guy, sometimes there's one rider that pays you to get to the races, right?
Yes, so at the races, my deal is if they're on a program with me and they're paying me, those are the guys that get worked on. It's a non-exclusive deal. I can't, that would be too much money. So, they all understand that I help everybody, and there'll be the occasional guy that comes into my office that's not paying. And if it's something basic, like, oh, hey, can you help me tape up my wrist? I'll help them out. Alex Ray is a guy like that. I love the kid to death. He comes into my office all the time, he can't afford to be on the program. And if he came up to me and something was bothering him, I would definitely help him out for sure. But I kind of let those guys know not to take advantage of that.
Yeah.
So, I have my basic guys who pay me on the weekends to be there for them.
Mm-hmm. Cool. I think we need to take another break, but we'll be back for one last segment with Doc G. We'll be right back.
I've been with FXR for, you know, going on 4 years now. It's a small company starting out. It's growing really quickly, so it's nice to be a part of those guys.
Don't try to be the fastest on the track.
Be the fastest ever. Work harder than everyone else.
Because dedication is everything.
If they say your goals are crazy, be insane.
Be fast. Be the crazy one. Be unstoppable. One goal, one vision. We have four colors right now. Retails for $28.95 at odigrips.com and, of course, your favorite retailer.
We put our heads together to both reimagine and lift the bar on what a modern motocross helmet should be. Opt for the highest level of modern technology and energy dispersion with the Fly Racing Formula helmet, designed for an elevated defense against a wider range of real-world impact scenarios. Globally engineered with the most advanced materials and technologies available. Outfit yourself with proven technology, lightweight performance, and elevated impact management with the Fly Racing Formula helmet.
Welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show, presented by Ogio Powersports and FMF Racing. Don Maeda here with my buddy Dr. G, and we were just talking about like uncomfortable situations, right?
Yes.
What's the worst? Like you've probably had some title contenders as clients at the same time. Before.
Happened two times, and they were probably the most awkward times ever in my office. The first one was when Marvin Musquin and Will Hahn were battling for the championship in the 250 class, and they showed up at the same time at the office. And Marvin was on one side and Will was on the other side, and they were kind of like just staring at each other. I was like, okay, G, say something funny, distract the situation. And you know how Will is, he's just, you don't have to say anything funny when Will's in the office. Yeah. He said something, he looked at Marvin and went, hi Marvin, good luck this weekend. And I was like, what a dork. But yeah. Like it totally cut, you know, it made everything really comfortable. And the other one was last year, Joey was in the office and Zach Osborne were in the office completely opposite from each other on tables, and no one else was in the office. I went, oh wow, I don't even know what to say. So I just went back into my office and I text Zach. I said, is this awkward? He texts me back, he goes, very awkward, please come back out here and talk or something. So yeah, it happens. That's the unfortunate thing. If, you know, helping that many people, that situation is gonna happen, you know, every now and then. So yeah, there was a couple times that that's happened in the office.
Yeah, I think anytime I've come to your office, I mean, I can't think of any single time I've come in and there hasn't been a racer of some sort in there.
Yeah, it
racer,
is.
Racer, freestyler.
That's the reputation, you know, whether it's a freestyler or, you know, a racer or just, you know, now what's happened is, you know, I feel very fortunate, and this isn't, you know, because, you know, you get to do shows like this and you have friends like Don and in the media and you treat racers and they post some of the things. Now the amateurs are starting to, you know, give me a call.
Oh, wow.
Oh, hey, you know, if you work on Ryan Dungey or Ryan Villapoto or whoever, you know, this guy hopefully knows what he's doing, so dads will bring their kids there. So yeah, there's someone who rides a motorcycle every single day in the office pretty much.
All right, chiropractic is it's a maintenance thing, right? Do you more so practice chiropractic like because guys threw their back out riding, or are you doing things like with joints and injuries?
Well, I hope I'm doing both, because chiropractic, you know, and I've used this analogy, and you know, in a couple of interviews that you've done with me to find out what I do, is I consider myself a mechanic, just like for the bikes. You know, some bikes need just tune-ups. I can do that. Some bikes are you know, they crashed and they need new bars and they need new this, a new swing arm, and I can do that. So it just depends on what that person needs, but I'd consider myself a body mechanic, and mm-hmm. we try and help people out in any way that we can. Sometimes it takes a little bit more. You know, we also do a lot of post-surgical rehab in our office. So like when someone does something with their ACL or a shoulder or a wrist, you know, we're able to do that rehabilitation after surgery. So we like it to be a one-stop shop there at Natural Health Sports Therapy, and we enjoy helping people in any way we can.
Mm-hmm. What was the biggest or toughest like rider injury that you had to help someone through to accomplish?
Wow. Something? No, that's I probably have quite a few, but the most recent one was Dean Wilson's shoulder. Mm-hmm. I mean, that poor guy, he crashed in Anaheim, I think that was 2 years ago now. Mm-hmm. And the thing just took forever. And the hard part is, you know, and I don't blame Dean for doing it, but like, instead of just taking the time off and doing the rehabilitation, he had to ride. Mm-hmm. So that was difficult to do the rehab while he was still trying to ride and still trying to maintain his, you know, his ride there with Husky. And it was just difficult. It took forever. And the poor guy would just look at me and say, hey, Dr. G, is this thing ever going to get any better? Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's hard. But yeah, that was kind of a difficult injury, his shoulder.
Didn't you also work with Josh Hill with his crazy?
I did. Josh Hill, when he tried to do the backflip, and he got compartment syndrome. You know, Justin Mulford has been coming in the office. Very similar injury to Josh's. Same thing. Very difficult injury. Crushed his heel and got compartment syndrome, and mm-hmm. had to, you know, graft some skin onto his. Those injuries take a long time, and they're a little bit more serious. And you got to be delicate with the way you rehab them.
Mm-hmm. What about acupuncture? Do you believe in that?
You know, I hate the word believe, because I believe in anything. Because if acupuncture works for one person, then it works. I've tried it myself and it never really benefited me, but I have patients who benefit from it. I think you got to try everything, you know. Mm-hmm. That's one thing. Chiropractic doesn't work for everybody, and I'm okay with that too. You got to find what works for you. I do think acupuncture is very beneficial. It just, for me, it didn't work on myself, but I do have quite a few patients who benefit from it.
Mm-hmm. And then in this industry, you've got several like ambassadorships, correct? I mean, or like brands come to you. Like I know you were at one point, or maybe you still are, like have a lot to do with virus. Yeah. And then the Power Dot, stuff like
and
that.
Range, which is a new essential oil company. I'm the type of person, I'm passionate about anything that that I love. And I've seen a couple of these ambassadors or people who have come to me and understand that I am in front of people who can make a difference with a product. Mm-hmm. Power Dot's electrical muscle stimulation that helps people, and it's portable, and it's on your phone. I think it's an amazing product. The Range essential oils, you know, we got Zach is using it.
Is that what that smell was when he was in
here? Smell, I smell like peppermint all the time, but I really believe in it. I think it's one of those things that really help people. You know, we had virus that's compression wear, and I've been very fortunate because people come to me and say, what do you think of this? And then I have a laboratory basically at my office. I have the best athletes in the world, motocross, skateboarders, surfers, you know, whatever it is, and I get to try these things on them. Come back, give me some feedback, and we come up with some pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, I was really stoked on the Power Dot app recently, because like when you first gave me a Power Dot, it was like all muscles, right?
Yeah.
But like I've got achy knees all the time, and I just remember my phone updated overnight and all my apps updated, and I was like, oh, I'll put the Power Dot on. And I rode my bicycle hard. And there's a whole different category of pain things and everything. And there's like literally some knee settings in there.
Yeah, we're trying to make it a little bit more user-friendly. Mm-hmm. At first we thought with the pictures of the muscles, that was gonna help people, but sometimes it actually confused them. You know, they thought if I don't put it on exactly how it is in the picture, then it's not gonna work. And so, hopefully it's a little bit more user-friendly now, but as somebody who rides motorcycles or mountain bikes, man, there is no better unit out there than a portable stim unit that goes off your phone. No wires, you can walk around, you can go on an airplane. I back it 100%. It's a product that I'm very proud to be involved with.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so in parting, because we're almost out of time, what advice could you offer viewers who are racers? Just tips to stay healthy.
Oh, that's a great question, and we could do a whole show on that, but I know our time's limited. The thing is going back to being like a body mechanic, your bike is gonna run the best when you take good care of it. And the same thing, it depends on what kind of fuel you put in it, what kind of oil you put in it, washing it, taking good care of it, making sure your chain's lubed and making sure everything. That's the exact same thing. Don't make it harder than that. Your body is like a bike. You know, be careful what you eat, be careful, you know, what you put into it, stretch, do all those things that you need to do, and your bike or your body is gonna work better than it can. Mm-hmm. You're not gonna prevent some of those injuries. You're not gonna prevent all injuries. It's gonna happen. It's one of those sports that's just dangerous, and you gotta be careful. Use your head, always wear a great helmet, whatever your choice is, but do the research, because what they're starting to find out now is the concussion thing is starting to affect mm-hmm. moto too. So just be careful, dads, moms, whoever is helping their kids out, make sure you got a really good helmet, because you don't get another brain. So that would be my suggestion, the stretching, and then find a good chiropractor or massage therapist or acupuncturist or whatever it is for you. Go and find one and visit them. That's tuning up your bike or tuning up your body.
Cool. Well, hey, that's Doc G, one of my good friends who's been a big blessing to me in my life and also a big asset to many of the racers in our sport. So thanks for coming on, buddy.
Awesome being here, Dom. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for watching. If you're in California and you're hurting, natural health, sports therapy, of course, bookmark swapmotolive.com. Like and share this video. See you next time.